Dead Buttons are keeping psychedelic music alive here in South Korea. This is not just an ordinary show. The Dead Buttons are speaking out against all types of women's hate and sex crimes. All proceeds are donated to the Korea Cybersexual Violence Response Center. Go wild, speak loud.
When I was 10 years old, I really loved the radio, and coincidentally, at that time I lived in Daegu, in Korea, and then there are some American military nearby there, so I can get signal from the US Army radio, and then I listen to the Nirvana or R.E.T.M. and yeah, that sounds, and then the sounds really kicked me, like, oh, what is it? Where does it came from? And then I start to dig in when I was 10. Yeah. There's some, you know, internet really helped me a lot. Luckily, my father, he bought his classical guitar when I was 10, so I was really interested about guitar music. So I took his guitar and then go to my room, and then I practice it every day, so yeah, that made me.
고등학교 때부터 베이스를, 고등학교 때는 기타를 쳤었는데, 20살이 되고 나서 서울에 올라와서 이제 다시 밴드를 시작하면서 베이스를 치기 시작했어요.
From the beginning it was kind of really hard. Also like trying to be famous or got some more audiences. A few years ago I decided to not to care about it because I just want to play and spread the message. Actually being famous is not as pointless for me, so yeah. And then after a few years, people are coming to watch our shows.
요즘 밴드 다른 뮤지션들이나 밴드들을 보면은 관객들과 소통하는 공연을 많이 하는데, 사실 나는 관객들을 전혀 신경 쓰지 않고 오로지 밴드 멤버들만 이제 보면서 공연을 하는데, 그 순간 나도 어차피 똑같은 오디언스 그 관객이기 때문에 굳이 신경을 쓰지 않고 연주하는 데만 집중해서 하는 것 같아요. 음악만 하면서 살기는 사실 힘든 도시인 것 같아요. 하지만 재미있으니까 하는 것 같아요. 음악을 하는 이유는 라이브 공연 때문인 것 같아요. 그거 라이브 공연을 하는 동안은 온전히 그것에만 집중할 수 있기 때문에 그 순간에 최고의 희열을 느끼는 것 같아요.